evening, ladies, as well as gentlemen. Papa Boris here. My friend Dan is here as well. We're doing a Druid run. We had a pretty comfortable grind win against a Paladin in round one, and then we lost to Aggro Rogue to double Sinister Strike in game two. That was really frustrating. Frickin' Cold Blood backed up by a Goldshire Footman dealt way too much damage to us early game.
I think it's more accurate to say we lost to a 6-2 on turn two. Yeah. To say that we lost to two Sinister Strikes.
That's true. That probably is true. But the Goldshire Footman was clutch because it stopped us from killing the 6-2.
That's true.
Gotta give her credit from playing with some unusual cards. Uber WTF Pwn. This is definitely a troll name. I would be very sad if we lost to this person.
What's a troll name? What do you mean by
troll
that?
Troll name is a name that if you lose to it, you like actually feel bad that you lost to someone whose name is that stupid. Uber WTF Pwn, I think, counts for that.
So what do we? I kind of want to send the swipe and the demolisher back.
You send back a swipe?
Yeah, we got three of them.
Oh, that's true. We do have three of them. All right, fair point.
I'm really aggressive in mulliganing to get to cheap stuff.
Yeah, well,
especially
on the thing we did because we got nothing to play here. Although we might have wanted to keep a demolisher. Well, hopefully this druid will have an uncharacteristically fast start for a druid and will give us things to claw and wrath. Nope, not a chance. Well. I guess if he's playing nothing, we can shapeshift.
Here
although,
we start the Druid War of Attrition.
Yeah, although this deck isn't like that great at endgame. Like, there's no Ironbarks or Ancients of War, so I can easily see a lot of Druids having a better endgame than us. Here comes the coin, and...
Demolisher? We could have done that.
Oh, man. That's
I'm sorry.
Annoying. We actually can't kill that right now.
We can't kill that right now, no.
The most we can deal is 3 damage.
We could... No, we shouldn't put out the big game.
No.
That's a terrible idea.
If it had more than 2 health, I'd consider it.
We could Wrath and Claw.
Oh, we actually could... Oh,
we
God.
We could kill it. Doesn't
God,
that,
no. No,
little...
I can't do that.
Okay.
I think we shapeshift here.
Yeah.
And then just hit it, maybe?
Sure.
It's just 1 point of damage. I think it's worth dealing a point of damage to that thing. So next turn we might have to... Well, next turn we can kill this thing off or see what he does before making any commitments. We are not catching a break here. He's got more steam. Oh, gosh. Ah, oh, man. It's getting kind of bad already here. So...
Okay.
I'm inclined. Oh man, there's just no good options. I mean, Dark Iron Dwarf, just to trot it out, to have it, to see what he'd say to it, might be the best move. This removal doesn't really work very well.
We could Wrath the Demolisher and then kill the.
Oh, the
one.
Piglet?
Yeah.
Actually, that's good.
I like
yeah,
that.
Alright, let's do that. For the wilds. Maybe we should have kept that Demolisher, and then we could have played it on turn 3. But then again, if we'd like gotten any of our early drops. That aren't big game hunter, we'd have been okay as well. Maybe he'll just shapeshift this turn and pass, and then
big
we'll be
game
totally
hunter
fine.
Could be really good against him.
It could be. We're just gonna pray for Ironbarks every time he gets up to 8
no,
mana
just
onward.
Just once. We don't want more than one.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, just once. Oh man, I think I'm actually okay with this. Unfortunately, Dark Iron Dwarf plus big game hunter is a combo, but not quite enough to kill this thing. However, I think Druid of the Claw should be fine here.
Do you want to just Starfall that thing?
Oh yeah, we could Starfall that thing. You're right. Yes, that's definitely better. Alright, so we're on the back foot here. We just keep reacting. We can't get any of our creatures on the board. But we might be able to next turn, depending on how bad or good his 5-drop is, the Druid of the Claw could beat it.
Oh yeah, hey, look at that.
Look at that. Alright, I think we just play the Druid?
Sure. I don't have a whole lot of confidence that it's going to live.
No, I don't either. I mean, he can kill it with Shapeshift and the Panda,
oh,
guaranteed.
Oh, well, I didn't mean like that. But something that's worse than that.
If we'd had a 2-drop, I would have considered swiping this and then playing the 2-drop.
Yeah.
But that was not to be. If we had 7 mana, we could have Dark Iron Dwarf and Big Game Hunter.
Oh, hey, look at this. Now, I don't think we should do the... I think against a Druid, I just like to keep the...
Oh yeah, that's fair.
Oh, there's Demolisher. Okay. Well...
I'm inclined to play Yeti, Claw, Shapeshift, and kill the Flesh-Eating Ghoul.
Yeah, we actually have enough for that. I would do that.
Alright. Man, it's nice having claws and rats, I gotta say. and 3 swipes. That's a lot more removal than I had in the last time I played Druid. So he's got 6 cards to our 6 total. One of ours is on the board, but he has the play, so it's really anyone's game. But we'll probably win if he does play something that the big game hunter can shoot down. Oh, he returns the favor with the Starfall. That's fine, though, because now he's on the back foot. As long as he doesn't have a 2-drop. Ah, he has a 2-drop. Damn it.
Do it again. Yeah.
That was good. This was like a Flame Imp that cost...
One more
mana.
See, though, that's the thing. Even that's not that bad.
No, it's not that bad. I don't think we swipe that.
No.
This plus Demolisher?
Or we could do that plus the Healer. Or is the Healer more valuable?
I don't know, the Healer might be more valuable.
Yeah, let's do the Demolisher.
The Demolisher would make him have to spend mana shapeshifting.
Yeah.
If he wants to kill it.
Right, and then we can shapeshift next turn to kill his bomber.
Right. Or it'll die to a stray swipe, depending on what he does. Oh, man, I think he's got... Oh, that was really good.
That's fine, we can swipe just back.
That's true, we can swipe back.
Because he still has to... Assuming he hits that, yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
That's actually just fine for us.
Oh, if only we could play a Boulderfist Ogre.
I think we still swipe here.
Yeah.
And then,
heal up?
Sure, yeah.
And changes. Wow, tight game. So we got the Boulderfist Ogre, which is good. It's, again, the same situation. We, like, kind of attritioned ourselves here. So we still have the same cards. One of ours is on the board. He has the play.
We're up on life now.
We are up on life, and I just really want an Ironbark Protector right now. Then we can play Big Game Hunter Boulderfist Ogre and win the game. No!
Oh, wow, that was a little scary.
That was a much better bomber. So you just played 2 mad bombers here. Let's talk about that.
Actually, it's my secret. I like mad bomber more than you do.
Dan, I don't think we can be friends anymore. I'm just kidding.
Like, there are times when you take stuff that's just, like, utterly terrible over Mad Bomber, and I'm, you know, even just like Mad Bomber is a 3-2 on turn 2, so
ooh.
The
Sunwalker.
I don't know the names of anything in this game. It's so bad. I used to play Magic, and you know, after you get to like the 3,000th card in your memory, you're just like, you know, that guy.
And that people know what you're talking about.
2-2 for 2 or something, you know, and I'm already at that point in this game. I don't know the names of anything.
That's weird. I remember the names. I guess I didn't play Magic as much as you, though. Wouldn't it be funny if you had a Blood Knight right here?
What's a Blood Knight?
It's a 3-3 that sucks up all the Divine Shields.
Oh, yeah, that thing.
Getting +3/+3 for each
one. I've had that where there's 2 guys on my side of the board with shields, and he gets a 9-9.
Ooh, nice. Well, we'd have a Big Game Hunter to kill it, I guess.
That's true.
The joke would be on him in the end.
Not really. It's still bad.
So I didn't play Dark Iron Dwarf last turn. Maybe I should have.
Why?
Just have a 4-4 on the field.
You know,
but I like keeping
maybe,
it in hand.
Maybe it makes me
the hunter.
Maybe it makes me play more badly now that. Wow, another swipe.
Wow,
what we're swipe buddies. Maybe just because like the ability lasts until only the end of the turn that I like want to get that advantage out of it more. I'm probably playing badly because of it.
Possibly. Well, we have a swipe, but we can't kill this thing unless we shapeshift and swipe. Is that worth doing?
No. I think we just want to play an ogre and...
I wouldn't want to play this now.
We could attack that thing to get rid of its shield.
That doesn't... I think our life total is high enough and he's low enough on cards it's worth doing.
Yeah.
So we lose 2 health for that, but... Well, 3 if you count that we could have hit him instead. But it's worth it so he can't deal 3 free damage to the ogre.
You should click on the water wheel up there. No, the water whip. There you go.
He has a nourish. Hey, we have a nourish. It would be nice if we saw our nourish.
Does it ever start going slowly again if you don't click on it for a while? I think it stays like that forever now.
Oh, really? I never noticed that before. I just love these vegetables so much.
I noticed that your vegetable bug isn't happening.
I know. They must have hotfixed it. Stealth patch. Stealth buff.
Well, we can swipe.
I think we have to swipe. Man, play Game Hunter. Come on, buddy.
Get
it together.
I think it's worth it to keep it in your hand, though.
Against the druid, definitely.
Yeah.
Mark of Nature. That's interesting.
That's excellent.
Well, so we swipe...
I think swipe the snake.
The snake.
Make our 6-7, 6-11, and taunt.
Yeah.
And then just hit him.
Hit his face?
Yeah.
Druid's are not the greatest at dealing with this thing. He'd need a silence, then our guy would still be a 6-7.
Because we're threatening to kill next turn.
That's true. Just on the cusp. If he shapeshifts, we'll be 1
well,
damage.
Well, right, yeah.
Frost Elemental, boo! Who plays with Frost Elemental? You know, if we got a silence, we could actually kill him.
Yeah.
That'd be fun.
We already used our all, didn't we?
Oh, that's right. Did we in this game?
Yeah, well, on this Mad Bomber.
Oh, that's... God, this was a long game.
Yeah.
No, wasn't that last game where we used the Mad Bomber? I don't remember.
I don't. There's been a lot of Mad Bombers.
He's just going to wrath that for a card. That makes sense, cycling a card. That's
so right. he's kind of desperate here.
Yep. We can kill that Frost Elemental with the Dwarf plus the Hunter.
Let's draw a card.
Maybe we'll get a Nourish.
Excess mana. I've never gotten that with a...
Catch an auctioneer.
With an auctioneer.
That's fun, though. Do you want to do it?
Yeah, let's do it. I think we're close enough and have enough stuff on the board at this point.
I mean, if he plays an Ironbark next turn, so
I'll
be
feel
it.
A little bit silly, but it still won't be too bad. We still get him really low. We kill him with...
That's true. We
throw
can,
the
we can,
2/4 power guys
yeah.
at it, and... I mean, that's whatever. Who cares?
This being taunt is pretty handy. It's, like, already saved us 3 damage.
Yeah.
And 4 damage with the shapeshift and, like, another...
It doesn't look like he's gonna attack it.
He's just playing dumb things. All right.
Okay. Well, we'll play. Yeah, he can get it down to 1 and be himself at very low.
Yeah. Wow. Well, Mark of Nature was a pretty good card right there.
What did we take it over?
Ooh, I don't remember.
It was a tough call. It was that or some kind of creature, I think. And we said we don't have any taunt. So.
Yeah, you made the case for us not having any taunt, and that was a good case. I said it then, and I'll agree with it now. Alright, that was a good win. So we beat a druid. The druid didn't have that much endgame, actually.
He might have just...
Yeah, he had a nourish. I mean, and he also cycled with a wrath. Like, he drew a fair amount of his deck. Got our daily quest complete for 4 gold. Woo! We'll be above 5,000 for a bit, if we can make it up to, like, 10 wins here.
I'm happy. On my own account, I've gotten to about 1250.
Ooh, nice.
By this point. I was struggling right around, like, the 0 point for a while, but I think I finally... started moving positive.
You went from like almost 0 to 1200?
Well, I mean not in a day.
All right.
Over like a month or two.
Yeah. Jane. Gay girl, someone I want to beat really badly. All right, so I don't think we keep the Cold Dead Oracle. I think we keep the Wild Growth though.
Yeah, Wild Growth. Should we keep that swipe? I feel bad that I made us send it back.
No, I think we should mulligan it. You're right, there are 3 of them. If there were like 2 of them, I'd keep one. But with 3, and depending on what she plays, it might be really ineffective. Well, this is fine, so we can play the Wild Growth on turn 2, and then we have a 3 drop, so...
So, yeah, I want to draw a Yeti.
Yeah, the Yeti would be nice on turn 3 after we Wild Growth. Or, didn't we take Ascension? I have not seen that Ascension.
We haven't seen that yet.
I have not seen it once in, like, 3 games. She has a turn 1 play, because of course she does. Luckily, it's not Mana Worm Coin Mirror Image, it's just Ooze, but...
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. Nope, no 2
hey,
drops for us, but that
for
will
her.
Work. Not as good against a mage,
yeah.
Unfortunately, because she can ping off the Divine Shield, but she'll have to spend 2 mana, and on her turn 3, spending 2 mana to
that's
ping
really
this...
That's really significant.
It's pretty significant. She has this ooze out here, though, to trade for it. Uh-oh, what's going on here? This is just temporary. Oh, man, if we'd kept swipe, it would've been pretty good. Yeah, I think we play this.
Yeah.
Shapeshift on here is tempting, but... Then we can't do anything else.
I
think if we had like a 2 drop or something to play, I would do that.
I don't find that tempting.
You don't find that tempting?
No, not with a 3/2 on the board.
Oh, I see. So let's say we're holding our like Bloodfen Raptor, the 3/2 vanilla. You wouldn't have shapeshifted this and played the Raptor?
Well, then I would have done that, yeah.
Yeah, okay. She chooses not to ping off the Divine Shield with her hero ability, which
is Oh, this
is
great. Now, super tempting to just... I mean, what we could do here is just make that... guy have a lot of life and be taunt.
I'm leery of doing that because it's a mage.
So you think
there'll
be a polymorph and then run her 1/3 into it?
Yeah, she can always... what I'd like to do is... Well, here's what I'm thinking of doing. Shapeshift,
yeah.
Kill this.
Right.
3/3, ping off the Divine Shield for maximum value to kill the ooze.
Yeah. And then
we have enough left to play this. Now, the problem with this move is that she can then use the Acolyte to kill off the Piglet.
Yeah, I don't like that. I would rather give my guy... I'd rather give our make our guy big and be taunt.
I guess it would be her whole turn for our whole turn. All right, fair enough. Let's do that. So we'll shapeshift. Kill this. Do that. And then let's find out if she has Fireball or a Polymorph.
Well, Fireball's fine, too.
I mean,
I don't want to see a Fireball, but...
Either way, she runs in with the Acolyte afterwards.
Yeah, but with the Fireball, it trades.
The Acolyte would die. With the Polymorph, it'd be really annoying because she'd get
two cards. Yeah,
Polymorph
would be bad here.
But it would be her whole turn, and we can play a Sunwalker afterwards. OP Water Elemental, so she probably does not have either Fireball or Polymorph is what we take away from this.
We should have run in first. That's a really bad case.
Oh my gosh, that's right. Yeah, so Dan is correct, folks. What he's saying is the Acolyte should have run in to draw a card in case you top deck Fireball or Polymorph. Good call. So here, we actually could kill this Water Elemental by running in this guy, and Shapeshift.
I don't think that's good.
However, another option would be just to play the Darkscale Healer and ignore this thing. Or a Sunwalker and ignore this thing.
Or... Is it too early? I guess it's not a good use of mana for Nourish, but I'm thinking, like, man, is it a clear time to use Nourish if ever there was one?
I don't think so. I think we want to put another creature on the board if we're not going to take her creature off the board.
I guess we'll just do the Sunwalker then.
So we ignore the Water Elemental?
Yeah, it's just a better use of mana. Like, next turn, depending on what happens, you know, we have some guys who are damaged and we can play the thing to heal some.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, if she pings off the shield and then runs in with the Water Elemental to freeze it, then we're in really good shape if we heal 2 damage from each of those guys.
Mm-hmm. I'm feeling pretty good here. I mean, the game could go either way, but card-wise, we're equal. We're about to draw our 7th. She already has 7, and we have a much, much, much better board, so she needs answers. And it's only 5. I mean, it's only turn 5 for her, which is kind of wild if you think about what we have right now. Being the first player...
Man, that Wild Growth was good, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. We were the
first player.
Yeah, we were the first player, and we played Wild Growth. I mean, it's just really crazy.
I think that was like a total mistake for her to leave that guy on the board when she had the chance to kill it.
Oh, the Silver Moon Guardian?
Yeah.
Playing the Acolyte rather than pinging it off? Well, it turned out to be, yeah. That is not the most impressive Frostbolt ever.
No.
She still has to run in with the Elemental.
Oh, is she going
to
hit that guy? Okay.
But then we can kill the Elemental and not get frozen, which is really nice.
Also, the shield, that's right, the shield does...
If we top deck a swipe, we could have killed our board. Alas.
We could still kill our board.
Yeah, we can. I think that's worth doing, right?
No, but I mean with the Starfall.
And
then ping the guy with the hero ability. We get frozen, but
well,
we have a guy with a shield on it.
I think we should use the Divine Shield because
before it gets pinged off. Yeah, that's fair.
Let's do this.
Kill that guy with the little bitty dude.
We could use the Charger to kill it, and then that would leave us with enough mana to play this. Or we could shape
just
to kill it.
Which is still a turn. Yeah.
And then we'd have the Darkscale Healer.
No, I want to save the Darkscale Healer
and actually
right
use
now.
It.
Yeah.
Do you want to do the
two
creatures?
Yeah, let's use the two creatures. I like that because this way, Blizzard isn't very good.
That's true. Blizzard is pretty awful here, and she still has to wait another turn for Flame.
And Blizzard is even worse if we get to use the Healer after it.
Right, because then this would live through Flame Strike, and this would live through Flame Strike.
Well,
and
no, not that guy, if not for Blizzard.
Not for Blizzard, that's true. She has a Polymorph, which is really good. She didn't have it like 2 turns ago.
Yeah.
Kind of a big difference.
Call on getting rid of the shield there.
That's right, yep. If we hadn't done it, the shield would have been wasted.
So, okay, so I think we can assume... Well, maybe not. Maybe she was just trying to save a point of life, but Flamestrike, killing a 1-1 with that if you have Flamestrike. I think now is when we should Nourish, because anything we play is just going to be Varro. I mean, even the Healer... doesn't really do much here.
Well, here's the thing to consider. The Healer survives Flamestrike, and it would make this
guy
survive
Flamestrike. Yeah, I like that. Okay, let's do that.
Now, do you then shapeshift rather than making a Berserker?
I would not make a Berserker here.
All right. So, we've got a pretty good situation here. Really, really, really dominating board with half of it surviving Flamestrike. And that means that if she plays Flamestrike, our creatures live, and it's her whole turn. If she plays anything else, our creatures might be able to deal with it, leaving us with the option of just playing Nourish for... basically the win at that point. I think if we draw 3 cards and are steady on the board, we should be able to win. Kind of sad that we didn't see any iron barks in the draft though.
I am too, but we got some ogres.
We did get some ogres. They're like Poor man's iron barks. The ogre and the sunwalker.
Ogre, I love playing ogre against mage, just because, you know,
it's a pain in the butt to deal with.
It really is, yeah. It lives through flame strike. It most, no, sort of lives through fireball.
Yeah. She doesn't seem to like her options. Gay girl. Wow, that's such a dumb name.
The guy.
She has the flame strike. Well,
this is great.
That's great.
I mean,
let's actually draw three cards ourselves.
Just draw three cards, a real one.
Perhaps first.
Yeah. I hope we got a Yeti. No. Oh wow! Ooh. Hey, let's heal up our guy.
Yes, let's please heal up our guy. So another flame strike would clear our board, but I actually wouldn't even mind because that would still be her entire turn. She'd have five cards left to our six, and we'd start things off with an ogre and a berserker, which is pretty good.
I'm honest that I would mind. I'd rather not see a flame strike here, but yeah.
I think we're in really
we're still okay though. I think yeah, we're fine here.
All right, so ogre.
Yep. And then play both of those guys, I think. I mean, a blizzard would be annoying, and a cone of cold would be annoying, but those don't get a less annoying,
yeah,
regardless of which of those guys we play.
Yeah, and then a flame strike here isn't good because the ogre just survives it.
Yeah.
And it's got enough health that she can't ping it off afterwards. Now, if she has flame strike and frostbolt, we might actually lose the game, but... Pugman
wow.
Too. Wow, it was very lucky that we didn't get hit by those earlier when we put the Mark of Nature on our guy.
Yeah.
Very lucky indeed. Yeah, look, Starfall doesn't target the enemy hero.
Well, okay, so... Yes.
Is it time for the Cold Dead Oracle?
No.
Depends on what we get.
Depends on what we get. Well, we're not desperate, right? We don't... I mean, we still have the advantage here.
The thing
so,
is that...
Do we, we run in with Berserker or the 3-2?
I think we should... Well, I think we need to decide if we play the Oracle or not. Because here's the thing. Imagine that... Well, imagine, whatever, let's imagine it's ice armor, or imagine it's some stupid thing.
I kind of just assume it's vaporized first.
Okay, so let's just imagine it's vaporized.
Sure.
I mean, the problem we have here is that what are we doing with our turn? We're doing nothing.
No, we're going to attack in with one of these guys first.
Right.
Just to make sure it's not going to copy a guy or something.
Sure, but what if, let's say it's vaporized and we attack, and
sure,
like one of our guys dies to vaporize. If we're not playing the Oracle, there's nothing else that we're doing.
Okay,
this turn.
Fine, well, let's play the Oracle.
So we want to play the Oracle so that way we can kill the Oracle if it's a near entity. And then we have things to do. Like, I think that was worth it. It's not mere entity.
Okay.
So who would you rather lose?
We do a little bit more damage if we attack with the 2-3 right now.
Okay, let's do that.
Oh,
it's a wacky one.
So it's a spell or...
Do you
want to
play the dwarf or the silver hand knight?
The knight.
Okay.
So it could be the invincibility thing or one of the spell...
So the counterspell would be the most annoying because it would stop us from swiping her face and winning next turn. Spellbender, as we've learned, would not redirect it if it's going on her face, but if it's ice block, then she'd survive.
Yeah.
Question is, does she have a third flame strike?
Spellbender doesn't redirect from your...
Yeah, I really embarrassed myself in a video where I thought, I was like, well, what is it? Like, I've checked through all the secrets.
It was the blizzard that we were playing around earlier.
Yep. And, because I targeted her face with a spell, it didn't get countered, didn't get spell bent, and it didn't trigger ice block. So I was like, what the heck? I thought I was going crazy. And then some viewers pointed out to me that, you know, I had forgotten that Spellbender did not redirect spells to the face.
Well, this is really annoying.
It is, because we could win if it's, as long as it was Spellbender, we'd win, but if it's ice block, we don't. Hey, we have another ogre.
Well, what we could do here.
Is Starfall?
No.
To check for counterspell?
Well, we could do that. I was going to say we could swipe her face because that would... Well, I guess that wouldn't check for either of them. Never mind.
It would check for counterspell.
Well, yeah, I know this supposed to play the ogre and then ping her face.
With shapeshift?
Yeah.
Right, let's see if she's got a way to deal with the ogre. She's had the answer so far.
The last arena I was doing, I was so lucky. I played so many times turn two... pint-sized summoner, and it was left alone, and I got a turn 3 Yeti.
Wow.
A lot, like...
Living the dream.
3 games. Yeah, it was really good.
That's crazy. I don't remember the last time I've gotten to play a turn 3 Yeti off a pint-sized summoner. That is rare happenings indeed. Alright, Sunwalker?
Well, so now we can
swipe her face to some benefit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Well, she's got
well
the
okay, now we can think a little bit more.
Oh, you know it'd be great here, the owl. Would be nice. Not a chance.
Okay. So what do we do here? We could just swipe the Fen Creeper.
Well, the Fen Creeper does just die to the ogre, straight up. But the problem then is the Sun Talker. What if we swiped her face?
Okay.
If it's counterspell, it would get countered. If it's Spellbender, we could try swiping her face again to see if it's Ice Block.
That's true. You know, Ice Block is unlikely, right?
It is pretty unlikely, but possible. Do you want to try that?
Let's swipe the face, yeah. And it's a good chance it's counterspell. All
right, so if it's Spellbender, we win the game if we swipe her face.
Yeah.
If it's Ice Block, we look really dumb.
We don't look really dumb, because does it counter it, or will it still do damage to every...
It will not do... The damage will get canceled.
But even to the other guys?
No, just to her. The other guys will still take one damage apiece.
Sure. Well, let's try it.
All right, let's go for the kill.
Nope.
Ah, it was Ice Block. We took a risk.
Okay.
So now I think we killed the Sunwalker.
Yeah. Oh, it did hit the other people. That's good to know.
Did hit the other people? We shaped it. I don't think there's any reason to hit the Fen Creeper, though.
No, I don't think so.
Well, okay, so now we are threatening the kill.
Right, we
with
have the...
Starfall plus Druid of the Claw, Mr. Flexible here. So if she doesn't have any more taunt, we win. Or life gain.
And we are pretty high life. We're not getting anything crazy like the... She's probably holding on to, like, two fireballs or something.
Yep.
Well, there's one of them. Got to start... And it was in the far left
car,
and she's probably storing those up.
Yep. Oh, that is music to my eyes. All right. That's it. That's the game.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Don't say good game first. That's so rude.
Really?
I think so. I think you attack, and then you got to be really quick if you want to say good game. But saying good game before you actually...
I think if you have the win on the field and it's visible to both players, it's okay to say good game. But if it's coming out of your hand,
before you play the game winning,
it does seem a little rude. Like that rogue was like, "Good, well played."
Right. Yeah.
Sinister strike. Ah, go to hell. Anyway, we're up to 3-1. Pretty good. The wins have been sort of strong. I guess that mage is a little bit close.
What's with the 3-win key? I don't like how it looks.
Oh,
that weird wing thing.
Oh, look at the keys. It's kind of like you.
You don't look at them.
You and card names, me and the keys. Just don't look at them.
I like the four. Once it turns into the book at the 4-win key.
Dude, well, you really pay attention.
I do. I hate how that 3-win key looks.
You don't remember what a Blood Knight is called, but you remember that the 4-win key is a book.
It's a book, and the 5-win key is the golden book with a sword in it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, Dan, we'll try to get there so you can see your beloved
Shubei
book here.
Okay.
Wow, nice opening hand here.
Hey, that's... I think I would keep a swipe against Warlock.
Yes, good call. Do we keep the Mark of Nature? Probably not.
No.
This thing is too likely to die, but everything else seems good to me.
He mulliganed two cards. I've been trying to pay attention to that more recently. Just trying to guess, like, what's the likelihood that they're just going to curve out and wreck you? And because that does actually affect. There's no 1-3 taunt. Side of the board.
I would pass the turn here because next turn if he plays something, we can play this coin and then claw to kill played.
That's a good point.
I don't want to commit the
coin.
Okay, now if he plays a 2-3, then that sucks.
Reach over here.
Dan is on the mouse right now.
There we go. Okay.
He did what I could never do. All right, so you cappy with Bloodfen Raptor claw with the coin?
I am.
All right. Sad that we're not going to be able to coin out the Yeti next turn, but I think this is well worth it.
I also feel a little bit of satisfaction whenever there's no weapon for that thing to kill.
Oh.
And like, not only that, but there's no weapon that we could have had.
Yep.
Do druids have weapons? Like, one weapon, though? Oh, no, I'm thinking, like, there's a couple hunter weapons.
All of their, you know, attack powers, them shapeshifting into animals.
Yeah, that makes
sense.
Okay.
Well, trade and healer? Or do you want to play the Wild Growth?
It doesn't speed the Yeti out. It's trade, and I kind of... Well, I like the Wild Growth better, actually.
Well, so it's a tough call. What I like about the healer is it puts a 3-3 on the board.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay. If, however, he does nothing on his turn, then I'll regret that we didn't
want to. That's all good. We'll still get the Yeti on the board next turn.
That's true. We're just trying to clear out here and win that way.
A few drafts ago, I was a Warlock, and I already life-tapped twice, and my priest of an opponent thought he was being cute and healed me. But, like, he didn't really pay attention to... I've been using life tap.
Oh my god, that's really funny. Trade in Yeti?
Sure.
Sad to lose your 3-drop to a 2-drop, but... And also, with his life tap, he got a little bit ahead. But hopefully the Yeti will be good for a couple of cards, and so will Swipes.
Swipes. That's like that old Scott Joplin tune, SWIPESY CAKEWALK.
Oh, yeah, I haven't heard that one.
That's a good one. It's 1897, I think.
So what I'm inclined to do here is to run and deal 4 damage and then heal up with the healer.
I like it.
There's a bit of a risk here, which is that he could run in and then Mortal Coil, but that would require him to lose the Fen Creeper.
Yeah, I mean, he's going to Mortal Coil at some point anyway.
Yeah, that's true. This is actually not super likely to hit versus a Warlock. I mean, on average.
Well, we do still have a couple power pumping things that...
It's true, we got the Dark Iron Dwarf.
Yeah.
Shadow Bolt, oh, I forgot about that.
It's not so bad. You know, I'm liking Shadow Bolt the more I play with. Less the more I play with
it. Yeah, me too. Well, my inclination is swipe and clear his board with Shapeshift.
Yep. Oh, I always forget about, like, that follow-up Shapeshift. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Looks like Wild Growth is going to be a 2-mana cycle on turn 10. I don't see us ever using it before that point. He's got 6 cards to our 5, soon to be 6, but we have some non-real cards here.
Just a couple.
Well, maybe he'll play a Venge Crow Mercenary, or like some kind of legendary, I don't know.
That's true.
Or like a giant of some kind. No, he's gonna drain life. I imagine he has a follow-up here.
Another Shadow Bolt?
No. Just call it Crusader.
Whatever.
No, he's not. Soulfire. So whatever. Drain Life and Soulfire. So he spent 3 cards to kill that. I guess I don't mind that very much. Well, what we could do here is we could swipe his face, pop Divine Shield, and Shapeshift to kill it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this Demolisher was pretty anemic, although it technically does survive against the Scarlet Crusader.
Yeah.
We could Demolish or Shapeshift and just knock off the Divine Shield ourselves.
I kind of like that, actually.
Okay. I assume you don't really want to Wild Growth here?
No.
Okay. So we're actually ahead on cards, but our cards we know are bad. Unless he wants to oblige us by playing, like, a Mountain Giant or... No, no, Mountain Giant wouldn't... A CC Giant would be playable here. No chance.
This makes our swipe great.
Oh, oh my gosh.
Swipe. I hope we hit him in the face.
Yeah, I hope so too. Oh yeah, that would be hilarious. Wow. No! Frostwolf Warlord, actually...
That's not even that bad.
Well... Oh, we can kill him with the Big Game Hunter! Oh, that's so great! Unfortunately.
Well, that's fine.
So, we have Swipe and Big Game Hunter. Is anything possibly better?
No, this is great. Hit him in the face.
Yeah. Oh, this is brutal. He had just enough... Like, that extra Murloc...
I know.
...made it die. We could have done the Dark Iron Dwarf combo, but that was pretty great. So, against a Warlock, getting to do this is really, really sweet.
Yeah.
God, that feels so good every time we get to use this thing. I remember looking at this in the old days, like, oh, well, when's it ever going to come up? But, like, it just feels so good. It's worth playing with.
Yeah.
Well, he's screwed now, I think. We still don't have any real cards to play.
Especially because, like, every single one of those Demolisher hits prevents him from drawing a card, basically.
Mm-hmm. If he plays 5 mana on life taps, I would not have done that myself. Hits the Tiger, that's a bit sad.
A little bit.
Oh my gosh. Well, I think we nourish.
Draw some cards, yeah.
Alrighty. That is so backbreaking.
I like the 3-3 here.
Alright, let's do it.
Especially because Tiger.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Shubei. You should,
Hey, there's a Sea Giant. He could have actually won this game if he'd had Defender of Argus or Sunfury Protector to follow that up with.
When you name this video, if you name it SWIPESY CAKEWALK, it'll start turning up in people's YouTube searches for ragtime.
It's great. So this will let us deal 5 damage, so we can't quite win. The question is, do we play Novice Engineer to hopefully fish for Swipe to kill him? Or do we play this?
Whoa, that's really aggressive. I don't think we should do that if we're not guaranteed, if we're not really close to winning.
Okay, so let's just do this, see if we get a Swipe to win the game on the spot.
Although we...
Hey, it's Ascension!
So here's the thing, is if we play... Now I kind of want to play that guy, that 2-2... who draws a bunch of cards, because then we could still fish for a win.
The problem is that
we'd
be at 5 mana. We could Wild Growth, though. Do you want to do that?
Yeah, let's do that.
Still be able to swipe and win the game. No. Not a chance.
Okay, so...
Sunwalker?
Sunwalker. And do we trade with the Tiger?
That's a good question. I actually think so.
Sure, yeah.
Because then...
If he's able to, do a point of damage, yeah.
We're taking the slow. And basically, the longer this goes, the more likely it is we're going to get a swipe. I think we've used 2 swipes here, so I think we have 1 left in here.
Oh, no.
It's kind of sounds, but I mean, he still has to. He can't attack us.
Right. Yeah.
So this is actually 4 damage.
And
5,
I think
6.
We kill.
Right now. He's life tapping. Desperado life tap.
Man, this guy should life tap before he.
Should have life tap, yeah. But, well.
Anyway, I mean, this is still good for him. Now we win.
GG. I forgot we had that. That's Mad's
card. And
then
this guy, yeah.
We could have also shapeshifted, but let's let the Druid of the Claw have his day in the sun.
I play the taunt version so much more frequently.
Yeah, I think under normal... It's very rare you'd do that.
But we've done it twice so far.
It was for the kill both times.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's why it's better than a Fen Creeper.
Among other reasons.
Alright, 4-1.
Book.
Oh yes, that's a book. I never thought of that as a book for some reason. Didn't stick in my mind in that particular way.
Thought of it as like a cube or something.
Just thought of it as a design, I guess. Learning so much here from Papa Boris and Papa Dan. The key at 4 wins is a cube.
Wait, it's not a cube, it's a book.
A book. Yes, it's a book.
I just know, this is the first time I noticed the book has those terrible wings behind it though. Now I like
it. Well, it builds on itself. Vivictus. Oh, good cards, but a bit early.
Yeah, let's get
it. Well, now, do you keep the Yeti? Try to coin
this
it out
is
on
against...
turn 3?
Actually, I probably would keep the Yeti here.
Okay.
I wonder if that's named after... There's that old magic card from Legends, Vivictus Osmati. You remember that?
No.
It was one of those terrible...
Before my time.
8-mana Elder Dragon Legends, I think.
I don't think I'm going to coin this out.
Against a warrior... No. Oh, no. We want to coin the Yeti out. That's what you
right.
do
Right. Oh,
with
yeah,
coins.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
And there's nothing good for a 3 either.
Sorry, War Axe.
Now I almost don't even want to play the Berserker out. It would just die.
Yeah. It really would do absolutely nothing.
Yeah, let's just... He can hit himself against the Yeti a couple times.
I doubt he'd oblige us in that fashion, but...
He might.
Well, if he plays a creature here, pretty much any creature...
I mean, he would trade a creature and a ping up the axe, right?
Except not an acolyte, hilariously enough.
Yeah, but, so this is great. Yeah, let's... Yeti.
If only we had an ooze. That was a pro-mulligan decision by us here. It really worked out well. So we've got swipe and claw. This axe, I mean, it's kind of annoying. I think we're going to have to... I think maybe we should have just thrown this out.
I don't think so. I mean...
The axe.
Who knows? I mean... Ooh, somebody became a level 3. I don't know who that is. But, I mean, who knows? I mean, he could be holding that guy who, equips a 2-2 weapon, and he's finding it awkward to use now.
True.
All sorts of stuff.
Oh, it's such a good combo. So he draws
good.
A card,
and he
then
actually
he's
is
the
able
Yeti.
To trade.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is still fine. We're able to... Well, we don't really... I guess we could claw that thing... Put out something.
I'm inclined to claw this thing and just put the berserker out. Let it die to the axe. I mean, if he's got more weapons, he's got more weapons. But I think it's better than doing nothing. You can kind of treat it as like a 2-mana deal 3 damage, remove 1 durability from your
sure.
opponent's weapon.
Sure. Yeah, that's fine.
I think you can get in a lot of trouble if you
try to get a little too clever.
Yeah, if you try to play around it too much. I mean, the only time we'd ever be able to play this is if, after we played Sunwalker, which is 2 turns from now.
That's true.
You know, if we got Ascension, that would be pretty nice.
We drew it last game.
We did. We drew it last game. Yeah, it was great.
The last turn.
Yep. It was not relevant. This is a shy Sanjin. Oh, jeez. That's annoying.
It's fine. He didn't do anything with it.
So do we play the Dark Scale Healer just to put a Yeti on the board, or do we swipe this, losing value off the swipe, so that his three power creatures can't charge?
Who cares about his three power creatures? Let's play that 4/5.
Alright.
It feels bad when we have an ogre in the hand. That'd be good to heal back up a little bit.
Yeah. So the real test of his turn is, can he kill this without having to lose the Warsong Commander? Because if he can keep this alive, the Sunwalker and the Ogre, I think, are both a lot less impressive next turn. What I'd like for him to do is just to play a Ventricle Mercenary. Then we can kill it with the Big Game Hunter, kill the Warsong Commander. Oh, the charges. Oh, so good. Oh, God. Oh, man, he's going to trade, and that thing's only going to charge as well.
You think he's going to trade?
Oh, of course.
I don't think he's going to trade.
He's definitely going to trade.
It doesn't charge anymore. Does it? Oh, it does. Oh, because it's a battle cry thing. Mm-hmm. No, he's not trading. See?
That was a huge error. Oh, my God.
Yeah, see, now we get to swipe.
How could he... Well, anyway, opponent made a huge mistake. He should have definitely killed our creature. Because this will die to swipe, and then that leaves the thing to die over here.
I had a feeling he wasn't going to...
I'm not going to complain, but that was a huge mistake. So now we can do that.
Sweep his board, yeah.
Yep. Huge mistake by our opponent, which I'm not going to complain about. And we pass the turn. So he dealt basically 5 extra damage to us, and what he spent to get that 5 damage was a Warsong Commander, which is really not worth it. I'm very happy with the decisions our opponent has made. All he needs to do now is play a War Golem for 7 mana, so we can play a Big Game Hunter.
Oh. Now he'll probably trade.
I don't think so. I think he's going for the face. He's committed. Just... He is. Oh no, he decides to trade. Well, I'm fine. I mean, nothing else a bad move. I just thought he was, you know, that kind of guy.
Yeah.
So the problem we have to keep in mind is that this can get enraged by the warrior pretty easily.
So let's play a Sunwalker.
So I think Sunwalker has to be the play rather than the ogre.
I usually will do that anyway. I guess not usually, but a lot of times I'll do that.
Oh, yeah?
I'm not safer. Sure why. It's because I want, if I'm going to bait out removal, I want it to be on the Sunwalker instead of the ogre.
I see.
Because...
Oh my gosh.
A little bit.
Slam.
A little...
Oh, South Sea Deckhand.
Oh, wow, that's really good.
That deserves a well played.
Was not expecting that. I mean, Ogre, a lot of times you can almost think of it as having...
Oh, my fuck,
oh,
that's
wow,
so bad.
Oh, wow, that's really bad.
So we're going to get burned out.
Yeah.
We can't kill this with Big Game Hunter. We have no taunt.
Oh, swipe.
We have a swipe.
Okay. This is going to be really scary anyway.
It is going to be really scary, because now we have to actually shapeshift, and I think.
That's good. We can still play the 3-2.
Good thing you made us take this card over the Panther.
Yeah.
So he
yeah,
us down
this guy actually has been really good the whole time, just having a 3-2 for 2.
Yeah. Well, he's going to get us down to 3 health, so, like, really anything else wins. Just anything in the universe. Because we didn't have any taunt. Oh, I think he's got the kill.
Here he comes.
Now, it's twice we've gotten burned out
or
by
he's just playing
decks.
Something else with another weapon.
Oh, it's true.
See?
Oh, I see. Mind if I roll good order.
Okay. Okay, so we have not necessarily lost.
That loot hoarder is going to kill us, though, if we don't get a taunt. Man, we need a taunt. There's
well,
nothing else that matters.
Let's draw a card.
Why does Nets Engine ever want to show up? Hey!
Okay.
That's really important.
Okay, so let's kill us 3-3.
The question is, do we shapeshift?
I think we shapeshift him.
Do we shapeshift or play a creature?
I think we...
An argument could be made for shapeshifting to kill the loot hoarder.
I'm almost thinking shapeshift to kill the loot hoarder.
Because then we go to 2 health. Some things will kill us,
yeah.
But not that many things.
I think that, like, the...
And then
the,
stopping it from being able to deal damage is pretty good.
Yeah, let's kill his loot hoarder. I can't think of, like, direct damage. Like, damage to the face that warriors...
Mortal Strike is one.
Yeah, but we die to that either way.
We do die to that either
so.
Way. Yep. Most of a warrior's burn is in his weapons. Now, if he can remove this, though, he's got the axe.
Right.
That's the problem.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, we weren't going to win next turn anyway.
Loot order number 2. Arcanite Reaper. Okay, so he's threatening the kill now with the Arcanite Reaper. So, yeah, it's taunt or bust. I don't know what else we have left to taunt. We use the Sunwalker.
We've got that one card. That...
Oh, the Druid of the Claw.
Well, the Druid of the Claw, we also have the buff spell.
The buff spell, yes, that's right.
So let's nourish and dig.
Nope.
That does not quite enough. Well, we can...
we can kill the loot hoarder with the loot hoarder, heal up, and heal up and shapeshift.
Yep, yep. We're going to win this, and it'll be great.
I mean, he gets two top decks, and he needs to just deal one damage. Now, he doesn't know of any minions, but anything with charge or any direct damage.
Yeah.
Even an upgrade. I've lost to an upgrade before. That's always heartrending.
I like upgrade.
It's good, but it losing
I mean,
to
he
it
has a
it's
ton
like...
of weapons. Imagine turning one of those 2/2s that he gets from his guy into a 3/3.
He
did have a mortal strike. Okay, there it is.
Oh, he's dumb. Well played.
Yeah.
I still think it was a mistake for him not to trade on that turn. If we'd had more taunt. You know, across any of these cards, it would have been fine.
So now look at this. For a little bit, it'll revert to the old key.
Really?
Yeah. And it'll turn back into the current one.
Oh, wow.
That kind of bugs me. Like, no, we're not going from 3 to 4 anymore.
Well, maybe they just are so proud of their transition animations that they want you to see them twice.
I hope they fix that before they release the game.
How do you know it's a bug and not a feature?
Because we're not moving from 3 to 4. It's misleading.
We're moving to 4.
From 4. Yeah.
So 4 and 2 are the deck I really think deserves better.
I do too.
I think both those losses were dumb.
Well, I did think that one was dumb.
The warrior one?
He's had a ton of weapons. I think that's fair.
Frosty Feet. That's a cool name.
Frosty Feet.
Can we be second, please? Thank you. I must protect the wild. Well...
send that back. Do we send the...
I think I'll send back the dwarf.
I would send back the dwarf. Do we send back the hunter?
No.
I think
we
so.
Can just play that on turn 2, this on turn 3.
Well, I hope we get something that lets us coin out something turn 1.
That's true. It's unlikely that we don't have that many 2-drops.
That's true.
Although Wild Growth, that's another card we haven't seen in a while. Wild Growth.
I'm not a huge fan of coining that out either, anyway.
I like coining it out. It uses up this 1 mana. I mean, it makes your coin permanent, basically.
Yeah.
I think that's a fair use.
That's fine.
Oh, Wild Growth, you're late.
Should be Wild Growth anyway, right now.
I think I'd rather play this just to put board presence out, otherwise we can fall
behind.
Yeah,
but we got the swipe. I don't think we're going to fall behind.
Oh, I see. You're going to gamble on swipe. Being
yeah,
good.
Let's
do all right, it. Let's do it for education.
Watch, we lose terribly now.
Well, that's what you gotta do in Hearthstone. You gotta learn.
It'd be a little bit easier if we had a Yeti also. If we had a Yeti and swipe instead of 2 swipes, then I would really be in favor of.
Does she have a cold blood? She has a cold blood.
Oh, whatever. Who cares?
Right, that was a pretty unimpressive.
And did, look at that. That's not even combo.
No, it is not even combo. So, do we silence that or do we just swipe it? If we silence it, we can also play this guy.
Yeah, let's just silence and play that guy. And then, whatever, I mean, he there runs it into the bird, runs it into Ossie, yeah, does something.
She can use the dagger to kill the owl, but then the 2/3 squares off against the 2/3.
Yeah.
She can use the dagger to help kill this, but then the owl sticks around.
I bet she has deadly poison.
She could do deadly poison, that'd be good here. Shatter Summon Cleric would be pretty good here as well. Buff this to be a 3/4, kill the berserker, kill the owl.
Yeah.
But then, this thing would be... Oh, it would be at 2 health. She'd have a pair of creatures with 2 health, so swipe wouldn't be
really
enough.
I just want to coin out an ogre next
time. I know, that'd be great. As long as her turn is just not that impressive, we can definitely coin out an ogre. That's a turn... Well, it's a turn 4 ogre, actually.
Whatever. Who cares?
Technically. It's pretty good.
I guess that saves her 3 damage.
Yeah. Well, she could have saved 3 damage just by dagger. Oh, no, she gets to keep the creature is what she did.
Right.
So, ogre or swipe to clear the board?
Swipe.
I mean, it's a tough call.
Oh, okay, swipe. Yeah, swipe. Swipe's better here. It's you have to take your swipe opportunities from you.
We can't do anything with the coins.
No, that's fine. So we get 2 ogres, 1/2 in a row.
Yep, so as long as her turn's not crazy with, like, shadow-stepping bandits, we're fine. This is actually great. I don't care about that. So she got a Yeti. Oh, South Sea deckhand. Boo.
That's fine. Trade with that.
Oh, lame. So swipe. We could swipe to clear her board again.
So let's do it.
Do you want to do that, or do you want to take this opportunity to play an ogre?
No, let's just swipe.
Swipe to clear her board.
Yeah. Just demoralize.
So we're just basically like using the swipes to wait for her to have a bad turn. So
something like that. Yeah.
So she has four cards to our four cards plus the coin. We never deduce that coin. Man, if we had Wild Growth on turn one, we gotta use the coin. So great. All right, that's a little bit unimpressive, so I think this is Ogre time, right?
Yeah.
Or do we play this just to feel more safe?
Yeah, let's play that.
Okay. This does make a certain kind of sense. You want to use the coin here to do the Hunter?
Yeah.
So now there's a decent chance... Oh, did I play around Betrayal? Oh, no, there actually was a way to play around Betrayal. I could have played this first and put this to keep the piglet in the middle.
You could have put that thing on the left-hand side.
Oh, yeah.
You get whatever order you want. And sometimes it gets bugged out and the Druid ends up in the middle.
Yeah, but if I just played this first, I could have put the piglet in the middle.
I think I've noticed that happens when I move really fast. Sometimes the boar will be on the right side.
Anyway, that was a mistake, because if she has Betrayal, she can actually kill the Druid of the Claw with it.
Not that bad of a mistake. Not quite as bad. There are worse configurations.
That's true, there are worse. Got a Golem, and... Eviscerate. At least she didn't have Betrayal.
I don't mind that.
No, I don't mind that at all. So now we can just trade that away for the... Guy, and against a Harvest Golem, I think an Ogre is pretty safe.
Yeah. Already used up the Cold Blood.
Good thing we got that Cold Blood Oracle. So what she needs to do here is play a War Golem.
That Oracle, if we'd played that that game where we were digging for answers, that would have drawn us the Druid also. For a charge. For one less mana, too.
Bummer, man.
We weren't really under any pressure that game, though, yeah. So there was no need to give the opponent a bunch of cards, too.
Oh, this is maddening. This Ogre. I was hoping she'd buff it with, like, a Direwolf Alpha or something, but it is not to be.
Well, we might be able to buff it.
We might be able to buff it if we get a Dark Iron Dwarf.
Or we could go digging for one.
Oh, jeez. Well, then we wouldn't have enough mana, I don't think. Anyway, that's all a moot point. Well, actually, it's not a... Well, yeah, we'd have 6 mana left, so yeah, we'd be a mana short of playing Dwarf plus Big Game Hunter. So, here, I think we have to respect the fact that our life's pretty low. I think we have to do this guy and then use the Ogre to finish off the Ogre. Oh, God, that feels terrible.
That's wrong. That can't be right.
Well, what else do we do? Do we let the Ogre hit us when we're at 16 health?
What if we kill the Berserker?
Mm-hmm.
Play another Ogre and then shapeshift.
Alright, let's give it a shot. It's a bit risky, but...
I bet, like, the Ogre just hits the Ogre, not us.
Well, we're kind of giving her the choice, because she's got 9 damage, so she has 9... Oh, 9 more in 2 cards. Yeah, she's not going to win this turn.
No.
Not. There's no way to deal 9 damage in 2 cards.
Not easily.
Easily, that I could think of. She might still play a Raid Leader. Buff this, come on. You know what she wants to do? She wants to do Defender of Argus, make these guys have a taunt. That would be really good, I think.
I'm glad we haven't run into Defender of Argus so far.
Yeah, I used to see that. I feel like I see that, like, all the time for, like, a little stretch there.
There was that crazy one you had recently where you could have gotten, like, 4 of them and also 4 of those bat guys.
Oh, yeah.
I got 2 of them, and even 2 of them sometimes felt...
Oh, my God! Please! Oh, well...
That's actually a little more than we want to deal with.
Yeah, can you cut back just a little bit on these 7?
That's fine, because we have the charge guy who can trade with that thing.
Yeah, we can kill and finish that off. I mean, I was hoping to use that against, like, the wolf or something, but...
I'm okay with this.
You should be okay, theoretically.
Yeah.
Oh, we got to keep our ogre, too.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Nice. Like, 2 ogres on the board's really good.
All right. You want to shapeshift again? No, I'm just kidding. No. Let's go ahead and hunter up the sea giant.
Charge into the other guy. And then do we... I think we kill the wolf.
Yep. And I think I'd like to play this thing.
Yeah.
What do we... Oh, we put the... Well, yeah, we put the ogre in the middle, make it harder to kill.
Right.
So if she wants to kill the ogre, she doesn't kill the anything else as well.
Although if I had Betrayal here, I'd kill both those guys, run the golem in, and then just hit it with the knife.
Yep, that's probably the best move. Fairy Dragon's happy to see that. That's not impressive here. So do we play the Cold Light Oracle?
That's a card so bad. I'm sorry. I'd make you take it.
No. It won us a game, I think.
It could have, theoretically.
And it was definitely better than the Murloc thing.
The 1-2 Murloc.
Yeah, we didn't get any other Murlocs.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. It's just, still. I feel a little bit of responsibility for that. Could have taken Secret Keeper.
Oh, that's right. I was running like, what was the other card?
You know what?
So bad.
Secret Keeper, I got screwed up by that, and I did not realize that.
Oh, it's opponent's secrets,
affects
too.
Affects your opponent's secrets, and I played out a Noble Sacrifice against it.
Oops.
That was really bad.
Oh, my gosh. That is, like, on turn one?
Yeah.
That's awesome. So it becomes a 2/3, kills your Noble Sacrifice.
Yep.
Well done. All right, so she makes a sensible play, killing off our hardest hitting creature. That does leave the ogre alive, though.
Yeah.
I don't think I'm going to play Cold Oracle.
I don't think we should play that. I think we should let her try to deal with this stuff. Oh, that's awesome.
That seems good to me. Doink.
And now we just make her come up with an answer. That animation went on forever.
Yeah, the mass removal animations could use a little bit more work.
Sometimes it seems like they fire twice, and I can't figure out why.
Yeah, that'll happen sometimes. Like if Lightning Bolt triggers effects, like Frothing Berserker...
Oh, is that what causes it?
Yeah, that's one thing that can cause it. It's so obnoxious. It, like, appears, and then the Frothing Berserker goes up by one, and then it appears again, and it'll do that for, like, every creature.
You should push it.
I should. Oh, Leopardome. This was another aggro rogue deck, it seems. It didn't work as well as the other one.
I've noticed a strange thing that people do. So people at the beginning of games sometimes will write greetings. And here we are. Like that book with a
the
sword,
wings, the book, the
and
sword.
It's golden. And when somebody says greetings to me, I always respond with a threaten. Because it, you know, it's kind of thematic.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'm trying to kill them. And at least half the time people will say back, sorry.
What?
I don't know why. It's like, oh, shoot. Now I feel a little bad.
There needs to be like a no problem emote, you know?
Yeah, or like I hate you emote.
Prolapse. That's great. Wow. All right.
Well, so let's keep the raptor and the wild growth.
So let's think about this. If we wild growth with the coin, we have 3 mana on turn 2.
I think the Stormwind Knight
We can play the Raptor on turn 2 and then play the Stormwind Knight on turn 3.
I don't think a turn 3 Stormwind Knight is all that good.
It can kill a decent number of
against
buffs.
A warrior?
That's true. Against he'll be playing new. Well, let's mulligan it. We'll see what happens. For education.
Yeah, I'm much happier with this.
Well, I have a turn 3 Dark Iron Dwarf now to buff the hopefully surviving Bloodfen Raptor. Both of our swipes. Well, 2 of our 3 swipes. Maybe we'll get a 3-drop, but we don't have that many 3-drops. Demolisher, though, would be pretty cool.
Demolisher would be good here.
If he doesn't do anything. Even if he plays Fiery War Axe, Demolisher would be happy.
Demolisher's not so bad. Why do we hate it so much?
I don't know.
I've
had just bad experiences with it, I guess.
Spits out damage, right?
Yeah, and it's got that 4 health. So it's a little bit tough to deal with. I don't know. I guess it's alright.
Yeah. And, like, compared to a dollar on mage, which isn't great, but
yeah, that's true.
It's not
sort
too
of
shabby
similar.
Either.
Wow, I like that. So
yeah,
he's not drawing a card off that slam.
I think we should just play Warfare.
Oh yeah, it'd be nice if we got something better. Oh gosh, this is a little bit too much of a good thing here.
We gotta name this video Swipesy Cakewalk.
Okay, I'll name it Swipesy Cakewalk, and then people will understand it's a ragtime song.
Yeah.
By watching the video and hearing you explain it.
Sure.
Well, I'd say the wild growth on turn 1 there definitely justified itself.
See, look, that was
gotta be mother.
That was really good.
Freaking kidding me. It's a good thing he's not a mage.
I know. I bet he's thinking right now, like, I wish I were a mage.
That was freaking idiotic. Well, what really sucks is that if this had been, like, anything less than the perfect Mad Bomber, the Darkscale Healer would have healed this enough and actually let us kill the Mad Bomber.
I mean, we could still
We could still do this, make it a 4-5 with Taunt and kill the Mad Bomber that way.
I think
way.
We should do that.
Let's do that. What's nice about it is if he happens not to have removal for it...
Yeah, these guys have a lot of charge things, though.
They do, but if, you know, if you ask your opponent enough questions,
then
they might run out of answers.
Then we can heal up reasonably.
Exactly, then we can heal it a bit. Make it return it to its 4/4 glory.
I hope we get the 3 life heal thing here. some games I get that healer and it just blows the opponent out because it heals so much across all my games.
That Arcanite Reaper makes me cry because
that was really good.
This is like normally I'd have you play something small against it.
Oh, we even got this guy.
Oh, jeez. I think we play this and hope to bait out the Reaper so that we can play this and have it survive in the future.
Yeah, we got to do something better than nothing.
That Arcanite Reaper was so good there, it hurts. Because normally when they play it, sometimes you have the chance to play something dinky and then have it be overkill, but we have all these swipes. Yeah, these swipes, so if one of these had been a Druid or the Claw,
yeah,
it would have been pretty good. Yeah. But I think in all the other games, we were happy
Swipes. Swipes are good. We're still going to find a use for these swipes. Look at that. I mean, that's great.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's going to definitely hit this guy because it bumps up this guy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's the sort of guy where you just need to kill it immediately.
Mm-hmm. And we even have a Demolisher to play afterwards.
Oh, it fits in perfectly.
Look at that.
Wow, can you imagine playing that guy after a Demolisher hits? Bro, that's really scary.
Oh, yeah. Because, you know, you get like a little bit of an extra juice if it hits a minion.
Yeah.
Well, he's got 6 cards to our 4, soon to be 5, partly because of Wild Growth. He's got the answer for this. Oh, man.
Oh, no.
Jeez. Well, we could swipe this.
Yeah, let's swipe
run in and shapeshift, and then still have enough mana left over to play a Berserker.
I like it.
All right.
What do we need to name this run?
SWIPESY
No, CAKEWALK. It's a
SWIPESY CAKEWALK.
It's kind of like the precursor to Ragtime before Ragtime was a term that people knew. That's why. That's how you can remember. It was written in 1897. Maybe you can't remember that.
No. I have a hard time remembering that. Oh man, that's lame. Well, what we could do is we could swipe it.
Or we could just Wrath and run our guy in.
Yep. This guy's dead anyway. Perfect. That's so much better.
Yeah. Okay,
Wrath.
Not that one.
Oh, thank you.
I've done that before.
It's a little bit embarrassing.
I've done horrible things with those card choice things before. Just like pick the wrong one because my mouse slipped or something.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
Now, I'm actually kind of play this and heal this up, even though it turns off the inner
Yeah, because he hasn't played any, what's it called, the Taskmasters or anything.
Like, there's
I don't think he would play an Execute on that, but...
Probably not, that's true, but
a Taskmaster, that would be good on that.
4 or 5 on the board's pretty good. So, he's at to 5, we have 3, soon to be 4. If we don't get a value out of swipe, then we might be in trouble. But he's probably thinking, well, he's played 2 swipes, how many more swipes can he have? Sunwalker! Oh, no, that's not good.
Oh, here we can swipe to the face and get some good...
It's true. If only this thing had still been enraged.
That's fine.
We can't deal damage because we used up our wrath.
Swipe to the face and then use the little tiger thingy on his Sunwalker.
Let me think about this for a second. No, there's no way.
Yeah. He's probably getting sick of these swipes.
Probably. So what's the best way to do this?
I think we run in with the 4-5 there, and then use the ability.
And then do we trade the Berserker for the Scarlet Crusader?
Yeah. I mean, we have a threat on the board. He needs to deal with it.
Can I play that?
I don't know. Warriors don't really have any.
It would have to be War Golem or
No,
Legendary.
You know what? I don't want to do it because he could have deal 2 damage to 2 random things. Yeah, that would be... And he hasn't had the... Well, maybe he has. I'm just trying to think if there have been any good opportunities to play Cleave yet.
Yeah.
But I don't want to give him any.
Yeah, that's a fair point. We're just slipping behind. Oh, Claw's not what we needed here at all.
No.
So do we shapeshift so that we can kill off the Violet Teacher? Or do we just trade straight up for the Dark Iron Dwarf?
Well, we're out of swipes, so the Violet Teacher tokens actually matter now.
They really do. Alright, let's do that. Sucks that we didn't get like an ogre or a sunwalker here. That could have made a big difference.
Yeah. Well, how many sunwalkers do we have? Was his sunwalker. Never mind.
Yeah. Do we play this to try to trade with the dwarf?
Yeah, I think so.
We gotta get some stuff out in the field here.
Yeah. We could have slam.
Or a weapon.
A weapon would be bad. Whatever.
One out of 4-3, so he's Also laboring under some bad cards, it seems.
No, these... Oh, no, that's so sad. Oh.
It's just one.
Cycle.
Just a cycle. Oh,
oh,
that's
now
good.
That's what... That's so good.
Let's
yeah,
make sure,
I...
Let's make sure we do the correct one
yeah,
here.
I, that's one of them I think I've screwed
ooh.
That up for.
Ooh, oh, I can't play that. Oh, that's
oh,
the one.
Oh, there it is.
That's the one.
Okay.
Is the one. All right, we might actually win this now because that.
What do you
may...
mean we might actually win? I've been assuming we're.
Oh really? No,
time.
I thought we were behind the whole time because he was just getting ahead slowly, slowly, slowly. But now we have a really good chance. We got these good cards. Ah, another.
Whatever.
Spot breaker. Yeah.
So what's he gonna do? Swing past it.
We have 26 health.
I know.
Ah.
And we can claw and hit his other guy and play an ogre next turn.
Yep. Is he gonna pass at 6 mana?
No. No. What do you got?
Oh, it's an ogre. Damn.
That's too bad.
Too bad we lost that.
So, I think we still hit one of the 4/3s.
Claw shapeshift?
Claw shapeshift. And then hit the other 4/3 and then make our own.
Since we can only play one card, we might as well do the ogre. We could have considered trying to be fancy with this, so that if he uses the ogre to kill that, we can pop Divine Shield against it, but that's probably not worth it.
I don't see how that's good. I mean, I get how it's good. I don't see why it's better than an ogre.
To stop our ogre from going down to one health.
Yeah.
Ah, Rogue Strike.
He's gonna...
Luckily, he can't kill us. That's a bit scary. He could have gotten us down to 11. So the ogres, are they going to just, like, rub faces?
Or he's going to hit us. Or he's doing, he's hitting it, something. It's a, oh yeah.
More kind of elites. It's a good thing we have a lot of health. Could have been a problem.
Well, and now this, we just kill that thing.
Yeah. It's actually quite perfect here. We can play a pair of four drops.
Yep.
Well, he'd have to top deck like a beast. Even Gorehowl wouldn't really save him at this point. Neither would Brawl, so really, there's
what's,
not much.
Oh, no, that. What about him. That guy that thought they're legendary?
Oh, Deathwing? Yes, if he had Deathwing, I think he'd actually win.
What's Deathwing?
Deathwing is the 12/12.
Oh, no, that would win. No, no.
So we played our big game Hunter.
No, I was thinking the warrior specific one.
Oh, the Grummish Hellscream?
Yeah, that would be.
It would only
bad.
Hit us for four. If
no,
have...
it'd kill our guys.
Oh, it'd kill our guys, that's true.
Now we got the cross swords. Next is the cross
so
swords with
wings,
a diamond in the middle.
The book. Oh, the one sword changed to a cross sword. Is there still a sword behind that?
No, there's no sword behind
it. So it does change a little bit.
Yeah.
But it kind of
and then
changes.
Next comes the diamond. Or the
yeah.
sapphire or whatever.
That's
it is.
The one that won't stop tinkling after you get it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, when you get to 7, 8, like 7 wins and above, it like tinkles for a really, really long time.
I guess I might not have the sound on.
Right now the headphones are plugged in, but neither of us is wearing them, so we wouldn't hear it, but. I've noticed that. I used to think the game was, like, bugging out until I realized it would happen every time it got to 7. Alright, well, arena life is on the line, and this is for the money. So let's do it. Shaman? Cool.
Too Bodacious.
That's a good name.
Really?
Is that a ragtime song, Dan?
No. God.
Do we mulligan this whole hand?
Yeah.
I think we do.
On the play, yeah.
If only Coldhead Oracle were a real 3-drop.
I asked this last time, but I was thinking about this more. I think... Almost every time I'd rather be on the draw.
Second, or the first player wins more.
Really?
Mm-hmm. According to their statistics.
What's the statistic?
I don't remember. It's been a while since Blizzard posted it, but there's a website where people track their own stats. Oh. Like people input their stats, and after like 65,000 arenas or something, I think first player has like a 3% advantage or something.
Oh, so it's like chess?
A little bit. It's a bit like Magic, too, where people think that the first player wins a lot, but the second player actually wins more. Here it's like the opposite. I'm inclined to play the Berserker here.
Let's play the Berserker here.
Because that kills totems.
You know, in Magic, I don't think that they think. I think that people tend to like to play first.
Right, don't people play first, but the second player wins more often?
It depends on the environment, I think. There was like, one environment.
Damn it, he's not even overloaded.
Yeah. One environment a few years ago where it was, like, it was, like, Onslaught block constructed where...
I'm inclined to play this thing. Would you do that here? Or would you play the Novice Engineer?
Yeah, let's play the 3-3. He could play some totems and be really annoying if he got the taunt to him.
Mm-hmm.
He's probably just going to Lightning Bolt it or something.
So I wish he had a lightning bolt at the previous one, then he'd be overloaded. But no, he's got a real thing. I'm afraid of like a Yeti or a Sengen. Ah, he has Sengens. Sucks.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
I think we use this guy.
And just trade.
Yeah. For the king! Of course. Storm of Nightmare. Good card. Good old card. Sorry, so you were saying there was a block?
Yeah, it was just Onslaught block constructed.
Okay, so here's the question. Do we kill this thing? Either by swiping it or by using Wrath and Shapeshift? Or do we just prioritize putting our own creature out there?
So if he plays something, I think we should kill that now.
I'm inclined to use Wrath.
Yeah, let's use Wrath.
Swipe could be more valuable.
And then play out the Demolisher.
Oh, would you actually trade your guy in? Or would you Wrath plus Shapeshift?
Oh.
The problem is Wrath only deals 3, so we'd have to Shapeshift to finish it off. Either way, it's 4 mana and our whole turn to kill this thing off.
I guess Wrath and Shapeshift is better. Although I do kind of wish for the wild. Although, yeah, leaving the 2-2 there against whatever totem Justin might play.
I wish it had been a 3 toughest creature so we could have killed it with
the
Wrath.
The problem is he's almost coming up to Fire Elemental.
I know. Well, this survives it and this survives it, so that's good. But then the 5 health is just so ridiculous. Anyway, he has a pretty bad turn here, just to taunt, or just a totem, I mean. And just to heal. Not a problem.
Not a
problem. Guess this guy will die. Do we swipe?
Well, let's draw a card first.
With this?
Yeah, I don't think we should swipe. Like my invention.
Oh, that would have been good.
I think we kill the healer guy. For honor. And then play the Yeti. Right. So the position doesn't matter at all for shamans, does it?
No, I like to be getting habits. Yeah. You almost always want the weakest thing in the middle for betrayal or explosive shot. It's coming out fast, but it's a fire elemental. Oh no, it's a flame. Oh no, he's gonna kill the Yeti. Oh, that sucks.
Oh, we can.
Oh, lightning! Oh my god, that's terrible.
That's really good. Oh no.
Oh my, that's.
Oh, that's really bad. Well, we should do something.
I agree.
So
we could do this as a charge and
I think
kill
we have
the
to,
Flame Tongue, but then...
You would kill the Flame Tongue instead
but,
of the...
But then he draws a card. If we kill this, we're left with
it's
the 4-2,
damage.
Which kind of sucks.
Yeah.
I think it's worth it, though, to kill this, though.
I agree. Oh, man, both of those are really, really bad.
I don't want a Wild Growth.
I don't want a Wild Growth either.
Let's ping this. The reason being he's likely to kill this guy off with the Fire... Oh, no, he can't play Fire Elemental because he's overloaded. But this is likely to die. So in case it is likely to die, this damage might matter at some point, like if it's a Demolisher or Swipe or something like that.
Well, next turn we could Swipe and hit it down to 1.
Ah, yes, that's right. So that is actually very important right away.
Oh.
He's going to heal it. Oh, but he doesn't have a good card, unless it's a Rockbiter weapon. You've got to be kidding me! Oh, my God. All that needed to be was not a Rockbiter weapon, and that would have been fine.
Maybe we'll get another Swipe.
Maybe we'll get another
and
Swipe.
And Super Sport.
Yeah, perhaps. Mark of Nature. Oh, that would have been so great if we only had just not killed our thing.
So I think we should swipe that middle thing.
Yeah, and then shapeshift to finish off
those.
And that seems better than playing a Demolisher.
Yeah.
Especially because if we leave these, it'll heal up.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't really want to play Wild Growth.
No.
That does nothing. No. Well, the nice thing is he doesn't have that many cards, but the problem is
we've got a lot of good card drawing.
We could make a 1/8 with Taunt, though.
That might be good.
Yeah.
Let's just, like, hit random totems every turn.
Yes, an ogre. Oh, that's not good. We don't have any good answer to it unless we get our own ogre.
We could get the Big Game Hunter and Mark of Nature.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's not just friendly minions.
Yeah.
So do we play this thing? I don't think we do. I think we just... drop our crap out.
Sure.
I hope for the best. And we make this an 1/8 with taunt.
We can't even do that and kill his guy.
Oh, you know what? You're right. I think we should kill the guy.
Yeah.
Hopefully one of our creatures will survive. In worst case, we can do Mark of Nature to plus
just,
4 attack and
yeah.
then 2-for-1.
Yeah.
Man, I can't believe he had that Rockbiter weapon. That hurt me deep in my soul. Oh my god, he has so much endgame. It's ridiculous. Earthshock? Who plays Earthshock?
It's like he's playing one of my decks with like six drops in.
Damn it. He's just had stuff all game.
Do you ever turn that blanket into something else?
Blanket?
If you click it enough, it turns into other animals.
Oh, I didn't know that. This is awful. I don't even know what to do here.
We should draw some cards.
This?
What else are we gonna do?
Good point. That's pointless. That's pointless.
Pretty bad. Okay.
Oh my god.
Wow, he even has a healer guy.
Yeah.
You swipe.
There's nothing to do here.
Not really. Well, let's.
Do we want to draw their card?
Oh yeah, let's do that. Why didn't we do that earlier?
We just really wanted to get that Oracle because it was a creature and cards attached to it. It's just better. Ah, Raid Leader, that's important. It's really important. We're going to lose this game.
Yeah, we are. That's fine. Six isn't bad.
It's not bad. It's a success. Oh, man. Those Rockbiter weapons.
You know what? I like this opponent. We should give him a well played because when we played the Oracle, he didn't say thanks.
That's true. I do appreciate that. On many levels. Oh my gosh, he has endless endgame.
Yeah.
And like, so he played Forked Lightning. He had two Rockbiter weapons. The only thing he didn't play was a Lightning Storm, but he never needed to. I think we can just concede here.
Yeah. I think we will.
Yeah, there's nothing we can do.
No, let's keep going.
So we can swipe that.
Yeah.
And shapeshift to kill that.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Remember, there's a harpy over here.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then just the no, I don't want to play that out yet.
Oh, why don't we silence the harpy so it doesn't wind fury? We say as though that is important.
Oh, that healer totem is so good. I almost wish we'd kill that instead of the ooze.
Maybe.
Wow. Maybe we'll just run himself out of cards.
Got too many cards for that, I'm afraid. Ooh. Starfall is not good enough. But we can shapeshift to kill off the harpy afterwards.
Yeah, okay. Let's do that. And the other stuff will start healing, at least.
Mm-hmm.
And then play out a raid later?
Yep.
We're actually not lost here.
Oh, well, we are. I mean, he's drawing extra cards a turn and he has a 6/4.
Sure. I'm just.
And he's got 6 cards.
Trying to be
optimistic.
These could all be alarm robots.
That's true. We could have 4 alarm robots and 2 angry chickens, and we.
There was one game where actually, like, my opponent did top deck a card, and it was an alarm robot.
Wow.
Where, you know, where we were both at 0 cards.
Empty wow.
It was pretty nice.
Wow, so, he's got like early drops too.
Like a swipe here would be really good.
Kind of. Oh yeah, I guess it would hit that, and that, and that, and that. But I think we've used up our swipes. Oh,
well,
do we do this and
no, 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 no. Play the dwarf.
The dwarf.
Play the dwarf. Buff up the guy. Kill his ogre.
Okay.
Then give your dwarf taunt.
I say so.
Yeah. And then kill his. Yeah.
All right, hero dwarf time.
And he can't break through all this.
That's true. He's only got 7 damage on the board. So
yeah.
Maybe if these are all non-interactive cards.
Right.
Yeah.
Gotta hold out hope here. Pay attention, class. And look at this. This is not actually. Okay, well, that's annoying.
Annoying is a pretty good word for it.
Yeah.
Man, he had all the removal. This makes me want to play Shaman again. Just take a bunch of good Shaman removal. And then beat your opponent down with a big creature.
Swipe here would still be good.
Still be good. Maybe he's not gonna notice that he has
the win on the board? I don't think he does.
I'm trying to be him. If he's like stream sniping us,
yeah.
Although we're not streaming, but if he's hacking into my computer, he might hear us saying that he doesn't have the win.
He doesn't have the win.
Yeah.
He does not actually have the win.
That's true. You need one more point of damage. He has 10. Wow. Oh, that spell damage totem is pretty good.
Yeah, it's really good.
I was hoping that Silver Moon Guardian would be a hero. Okay, okay. Well, we have the piglet, so... Oh, nope, never mind. Swipe. If we get a swipe, we'd be back in this game.
Oh, nourish. We'll nourish into a swipe.
Yep, nourish into swipe. Let's do this. Hit? Nope. Hit? Nope.
Hey! Oh, let's do it. Okay,
what do we swipe? The Shenzhen? This guy, I think.
Really?
Well, oh, we can't kill this engine with it. Oh, we can use Claw to finish it off. Yeah.
Oh, wow, that didn't even really clear what she was born. I wanted it to have one of those cool effects where they all compress at once.
If he lets us play a Sunwalker on the next turn, maybe he won't notice that he has the win. Maybe he'll misclick with his removal spells and kill his own creatures. You never know.
I had a poor guy... the Hammer of Wrath. What is that? The Paladin spell that hits 3 damage and draws a card?
Hammer of Wrath?
Hammer of Wrath. Yeah, I had a poor opponent who hit himself with that the other day.
But at least you got to draw a card. I mean, it's kind of like a Flame Imp, so you know, you draw a card, but you have to deal damage to yourself. That seems pretty fair.
Yeah.
Alright, well, that is that.
That didn't go so bad.
It wasn't too bad. Thank you folks for watching. If you enjoyed this Tag Team Arena special, do please like and or subscribe. And if you want to stick around, let's go ahead and take a look at these prizes. Yep. And hey, we broke 100. That's good. There's two types of 6 wins. There's like the good kind above 100, and there's the crappy kind of. It's around 80. It's very swingy. We got the good kind here. 120 gold is fine. So let's take a look at our pack. 49 is not 5,000. Legendary. Oh, the first one was a rare. I was so excited, but then it turned out it all sucked.
So 40 dust.
Probably.
Oh no. Oh, that's
Golden Innervate. Yeah.
Let's take a look at that thing. I haven't seen that before. That's cool.
Some druids still have flashbacks from strangers yelling Innervate me at them. I guess that's a World of Warcraft.
That must be
joke.
Some World of Warcraft joke where druids are like bottom of the pecking order and people run around making demands of them.
Maybe I think druids are good, but they probably just that's why people would play Druid, maybe, if they were really good. When people wanted your innervates for some reason. Next arena is gonna be... Warlock, Mage, or Paladin. So thanks again for watching, folks, and we'll see you again next time.